use this one. Okay. This presentation is about Stiller. Probably you know E-Stiller Light, which was bundled with Ecom Station, or you know also Smart Windows, which is the full product. And I worked on this program to make some enhancement and to have a better graphics output. Okay, so we have a better looking application on OS 2. So, okay, I'm skipping this one. So, here you can see how we title bars were painted in the past. With first, we have OS 2.0. Then there is an, the first one is warp 3, okay. Then there is a screenshot with warp 4 and a screenshot with Ecom Station, okay. The first two screenshots were done without enhancers, while Ecom Station was running the E-Stiller Light enhancer. And you see that the title bar has a different font, has a centered text, has a different background, okay. And this was the starting point from where I started working. And then with the use of Cairo, which is a graphics library, now we have a completely different result. Probably you don't really see how a text is getting better now, because the text is too small to see aliasing, okay. But on your display, it makes a really big difference, okay. And usually, to get a better, good looking text, you need a good font. So, for example, if you use an old Arial, for example, it's not good. You need to use newer fonts because they are getting better with FreeType. Also, with Cairo, you can use UTF-8 to show titles in the title bar. So, for example, when you use Firefox to browse a site, for example, in Russian, now you have in the title bar you can see an underline, because he has replaced the text with nothing. But with Stiller, the new Stiller, you can see the real text in Russian characters. And this works for every existing application. So we don't need to change application to use this new feature. Also, this has been the first thing I did on Stiller, so to get title bars with a better looking. Then I started looking at code, and I tried to do something more. And after working on title bars, I worked on push buttons. Okay, on the left you see a standard push button, and on the right there is a one with anti-aliasing. Okay, and you see the text is looking much better. I think you can see. Do you see from the because? Okay. So, those are the two kind of controls that I have replaced in the in drawing, okay. And also, I did some work, and now I can also change title bar buttons, okay. This is the same feature that you were having with the team manager in Ecom Station. But if you remember, the team manager had to reboot to change the graphics. Here, which you have a change on the fly. You just change the team, you click apply, and you have new buttons on the title bar. So it's a completely different system, and much easier, and a lot easier to use. Okay. To do this, I used some. Yes. The size, you have to change the size of images just to show them when here, because it's not the real size, okay? Because otherwise it was too small to show here. So you need to compare on your display the things, okay? To get here, I had to add a new code to handle the new graphics engine, but also I used some old code from the Smart Window full product, okay? So I merged a part of the code from the full product into the small application, into the light application. Oh, I think that the results are quite good, okay, because the text looks really bad, really good if you have a high resolution display. And why I choose to use Cairo? Because Cairo is a graphics engine, so it allows you to do a lot of things in the graphics field. It has support for many different things that, for example, are not available in OS2 Presentation Manager, but mainly because it supports aliasing on the text, so you can get a better looking text. I used the text aliasing only for title bars and for buttons, but not for all other stuffs. Also, if you use Cairo, you can have transparency support, which is not available on OS2. And another reason to use Cairo is because it is used in Firefox. Okay. That means that Cairo is working well. It's a well-tested library. Okay. And also, we are maintaining the Cairo source code to the latest level because we need it for Firefox. So I didn't have to get some new libraries to work, okay? I just used what was already running, what was already working well in OS2, and with a lot of work, I got to this place. Obviously, Well, another reason to use Cairo, it is because it is quite easy to use it. If you look at this, there are two examples here, one for drawing a pattern in a rectangle and another to draw some text. As you can see, it's quite easy to use it because it's a natural language function call, while OS2 Presentation Manager is using very strange function names. You have to do strange things to draw. Here, it's quite simple. You draw a rectangle, you set the color, you fill it. So it's when you know the available function in Cairo, it's quite easy to draw something new. And so you can, if you have some nice idea about how to draw a button, how to draw a title bar, it's quite easy to replace the code and put a new function. So we can add many different things, newer things that are not today available. Okay. As I told you before, not everything is working. I mean, I worked only on title bars and on buttons. So for example, I'm not supporting icons in the buttons, but usually most applications today are not using small icons inside the buttons, so this is not a big problem. Oh, another thing that I'm not supporting now is use of bitmaps to draw the button background, because you can get similar results using Cairo functions, because you can draw a shade, you can draw a gradient very easily, so it's not really needed to use a bitmap to change the background. Another big problem, another problem is the font mapping. Why? Because I'm using a very simple API in Cairo to draw texts. And this API is not supporting, is not doing a very well, a very good mapping of fonts from OS2 fonts to Cairo fonts. And so maybe sometimes you select a font and you see a completely different result because the font matching is not working and maybe it's Cairo is selecting a different font. So you have to try different OS2 fonts until you find the one that looks good in Cairo, in Cairo. In this regard, there is another API in Cairo which allows a better font matching, but it requires some coding to do a better work. So when I will find some time, I will try to get a better matching. Another problem is with the stack, because Cairo requires a lot of memory to make drawings. So it is not working with the small applets you have in OS2. I mean, older applets that were compiled with a very small stack. In this case, so you need to exclude this application from the enhancement. Okay. Also, maybe we can try to make the stack bigger. There is also this one, but it depends on how you work. And this is, yeah. Maybe I will find another way to fix this tech issue, but I didn't use too much time to see what's wrong, really. So, well. Obviously, there are a lot of things that can be done to have a better enhancement. For example, I can add a theming also for radio and checkboxes. Okay, because checkboxes and radio buttons should be replaced, so you can have an on-the-fly bitmap change also on them. So how you can write a theme for the title bar buttons, for the radio buttons, for the checkboxes, and have a similar look and feel for all presentation manager controls. And this task could be done quite easily. I just need to use the same code for title bar and replace radio buttons, classes, and so on. Another problem is the Windows list program, because it works well, but again, it is not able to display UTF-8 texts. So you can see Firefox showing a correct title in its title bar, for example, in Russian. In the Windows list, you get a straight line instead of a title, because the Windows list is not able to show UTF-8. And so a new Windows list handler is required, but here I don't know how to write one. Maybe if someone has some ideas, we can try to replace it. And other than radio and checkboxes, there are also other presentation manager controls. But for example, static text. I'm not going to replace also them, because probably it will take a lot of time to repaint the entire Windows for an application. So while repainting a title bar, repainting a button is quite fast, because usually text is very short. If you start replacing all strings inside the window, probably the drawing will get too much slow, okay, and so it's not worth to implement. Usually, given they have to a status, I think, that replacing a title bar and buttons is already quite enough to see a different looking application. Okay. And so this is a very short presentation because Roderick asked me to write one on the fly. Okay, so I tried to do my best. So now at the end, if you have some question.
Are you working on just the light version of this file or also the full version?
The Sparkle Municipal? On the light version. Yes, because the full version is doing a lot of things. And so I don't think it's good for the average user. I think it's complex also for me because you have a lot of options, while the light application is quite easy to use. You have only to choose the title, the color, okay, the theme, and then you are done. The full product has many things. Who has?
I'm just ignorant. What runs under Caro? No. Caro is a library, runs on top of Alara software. What is that now?
What's a library?
Nothing. Caro is a library.
Right. And it issues direct commands?
No. It's a direct bitmap manipulation library.
So it's using a bitmap model?
Internally? Yes.
Yes. Caro is when you use Caro function, it is drawing to an internal memory. Okay. And when you ask him, he is splitting this internal memory to the OS2 presentation manager window.
So when Caro starts, you give it the presentation space handle, and then Caro does the rest.
No, it's bitmap, but you have to split it to the
window. You do a splitting, yes.
Direct memory to direct memory transfer.
No, you just do a bitmap split. So you don't need to do other things. You just ask Caro to redraw the surface, and he does a bitmap split to the surface, to the presentation space you are giving. That's all. This is why I was telling before that Caro is very easy to use, because you just write your functions and you tell, okay, show it. It's very easy, and you don't need to care about aliasing and many other things. For example, I didn't put in the presentation, but now I have, for example, also the buttons with round borders. Instead of a rectangle, I have added round corners. Sorry, it was quite easy to do. So, other questions? No.
Well, is there any way around the problem with small applets, other than telling it not to work on? In other words, like volume control, for instance, didn't have enough
pieces of space. No, I don't. Rise your level.
You said that the reason that small applets would crash is because they didn't have enough space, stack space.
You mean space in the control, you mean?
Yeah, and volume control is one of those applets that crash.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Even the full slider will crash.
Ah, okay. Yes, but probably they are crashing for the same reason, because these enhancements are adding new functions inside the drawing code, and this requires more memory.
Yeah.
And the Caro requires more memory than the other, yes. Yeah.
So is there any way around that, or is the only option
going to be? But I remember there was a tool to raise the stack size on applications. In the toolkit there was some program to do this, but I need to check. Because if this tool works, we can just use this tool to change the stack size on all the programs we know that are failing.
Exceder,
yes. Yeah, but I tried to use it and I didn't get I got a not working application at all. So maybe it corrupted something, or I used the wrong parameters to for it. No. Other questions?
Oh.
Okay. Thank you for attention.